a little bit towards the Boston Celtics. But the first thing we will talk about, of course, we're going to talk about LeBron James. So LeBron James, he just signed, of course, with the Los Angeles Lakers. And immediately after signing, the Lakers made some questionable decisions as to who they're going to sign. They ended up signing, of course, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, 12-year deal. They signed Rajon Rondo. They signed Lance Stephenson. And a lot of people are speculating because this is definitely not the roster you're used to seeing from LeBron James. LeBron James, traditionally, he needs to have shooters around him, needs to be able to spread out the floor. But the Lakers aren't trying to be like Cleveland. They're trying to have their own identity and what they do with LeBron James. LeBron, he's now getting up there in age. He knows he has to make that transition that Kobe made, that same transition that Michael Jordan made. And LeBron is built to make that transition, and that transition is playing a little bit more in the post and playing a little bit more off ball. We knew this could happen. When there were rumors that he could go to the Philadelphia 76ers, a lot of people were saying LeBron's going to have to play off ball, but they're also saying that he is kind of welcoming the idea of playing off ball a little bit more and that he would prefer to play off ball. He just never really had a playmaker that allowed him to do that. And we know with Cleveland's roster before, who was really going to carry the ball down the court every single time that somebody you could trust? They really didn't have that at all. George Hill wasn't that guy. Isaiah Thomas wasn't that guy. Derrick Rose wasn't that guy. They never had a guy who you could definitely trust. Now, in L.A., you have Lonzo Ball. You have Rajon Rondo. You could trust both of them to make the right decisions. Yes, Lonzo isn't the best shooter in the world. Rajon Rondo, they're not the best shooters in the world. But they're really smart, have a really good basketball IQ. And even a player like Rondo, LeBron has never played with a guy who could get you 30 assists in an NBA game. Yes, he's not going to do that all the time, but the fact that Rondo has those nights where he goes off of 15, 20, 22 assists is definitely remarkable, and LeBron James could benefit from a player like that. So people don't like change. So all of a sudden, they're going to say the Lakers are making terrible decisions because you haven't seen LeBron off the ball. But LeBron has a body that's built for it, 6'8", 260, and especially in a league now where players are smaller. You're going to look at teams go small ball, and LeBron James could just bully just about any player in the NBA that's not a center. So I do like what the Lakers are doing. I might be one of the anomalies out there, but I really do like the moves that the Los Angeles Lakers are making. They also have playmakers. They also have guys who could get after it on defense. Rajon Rondo, not the same defensive guy that he was with the Boston Celtics, but he's still a very good defensive player. Lance Stephenson, when motivated, probably won't happen until the playoffs, of course. He's a pretty guy who could go after it. Yes, he never shut down LeBron James, but who have you seen go after LeBron the way Lance Stephenson went after LeBron James? So I like that signing. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, I think he could have somewhat of a bounce-back season. He wasn't terrible last year, but definitely took a step back and regressed a little bit. But now you have somebody in LeBron that can find you in the corner. You can sit there and you can knock down a three. You can play defense. Just focus on the defense side of the ball. It makes sense there. The Lakers still have to address what they're going to do at center. And I do think it'll end up being Brook Lopez, just because the market for Brook Lopez really isn't there. The market for centers right now really isn't there. And when you see DeMarcus Cousins signing for $5 million, Brook Lopez can't get that much more than Dwight Howard or DeMarcus Cousins. They didn't sign for a lot of money. I do think you'll be able to get Brook Lopez for extremely cheap, and I think he'll end up being the center once again for the Los Angeles Lakers. So I do like the roster they are building around him. Mo Wagner, he's been looking pretty good to me during summer league. Now, I'm going to get a chance to see him face-to-face, hands-on, on Saturday in Vegas during the summer league there. But what I've seen over television in Sacramento, he looks like he could be a pretty decent player. I didn't really follow him too much at Michigan State, but he looks like he could be a pretty decent player for the Los Angeles Lakers. So LeBron James could be potentially moving to the post and playing more out of there. I think it's a great move. You've seen a lot of players kind of transition in that. LeBron James definitely has the ability to do that. And if he does, and the Lakers roster that's being built around him, I think this is a better team than Cleveland was last year. A lot of people are just kind of not counting the Lakers in there. I don't think they're a championship contending team, but I heard some people say maybe they might not make the playoffs. I don't think that's true at all. The Lakers, definitely a playoff team, and I kind of put them even right now without a second star player because I do believe in LeBron James coming out the post I think they were kind of in that second or third tier type of team in the Western Conference. They will finish with a 6-5, maybe even a 4 seed in that conference. We'll see what happens, though. But I do like LeBron there. I like the players that they built around him. And I can see the play style that they're trying to go with. And I definitely do like it for LeBron James. Now, anyway, the next thing we're going to be talking about today is Kawhi Leonard. And he can be...